times for each other at the private.
Fascism to breathe. Fascism.
acquiesce to the authority. Fascism is defeated by people not complying. And this is why my friend here, Piers Corbyn, dubbed the slogan, resist, defy, and do not comply.
Absolutely clear. It is the road to Nazism. It's the road Subdivisionism, as Jeff has completely explained very well. Now, I think maybe rather than carry on talking here, we ought to go to the next one. And I know that Debbie's got stuff to say about lobbying MPs and all that, because we now... You want to say it here? Okay, okay. Because we now have, as I said in many places, there's only 4 weeks left before they try a new lockdown. And if they don't do it, that'll be because of our movement. But we're 99% sure they will, because they've got it already. And we know the numbers will go up because of what they're doing. The jab itself is causing the numbers of whatever they want to go up. So we're lobbying MPs right now to say no to any imposition of vax passporting. So this is a really most important campaign politically for some time. And Debbie Hicks here, who was my organiser during the GLA mayor election, she's been key in this. So Debbie, do you want to say a few words?
Okay, nice, what do we want?
Freedom!
What do we want it?
No!
Freedom!
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 Freedom! Freedom!
Okay, so before I start, I just want to actually say a huge thank you to Piers. Time of it lately with, let's be honest, the 77th Brigade, the media, the deep state, and that's what it is, it's the intelligence services doing, is trying to set him up. This man, and I've got to know him, and I class him as a friend, this man is the most unmaterialistic person that's not concerned with money. All he's concerned about every day of his life at the moment is going out and doing everything he can to stop this tyranny. So I just want to say, carrying on in your resistance, so that's a real mark of your character and who you are, thank you. But also, we're standing outside quite aptly at a pub called The Murderers. What a name. As soon as I heard that, I thought, it sent a chill down my spine. A pub called The Murderers that is not going to allow people in that haven't had the vaccine. We should stop calling it vaccine, we know it's not a vaccine.
It's not a shot.
As Jeff said, this is something that's going to alter our DNA. And we also know that it is an experiment. And for those that doubt this stood here today, please stop taking our word for it. Stop taking the newspaper's word for it. You should know by now that newspapers lie, that the TV lies. Check it out for yourself by checking the pharmaceutical papers and papers that they've produced that show that it's part of a trial. So if you're taking the vaccine, you are part of a trial. It's an experiment. And this is why most of us that are stood here, most of us that are going around the country, we are not happy with just being called anti-vaxxers. We are pro-liberty.
Yeah.
Of course some of us are anti this particular device or injection, because that's the appropriate word to use, but we're not all anti-vaccines in terms of the history of vaccine. Not all of us share that opinion. I've been vaccinated when I was younger and my son was vaccinated. I see things differently now, but stop pinning these ridiculous labels on us.
Yes!
Stop!
Yes.
We're not anti-vaxxers, we're not right-wing racists, we're not extremists, we are libertarians! And you know what? We come from every background. I'm still a light person here that's from a different political background to myself. I've met people from all different backgrounds that have voted for different parties. Do you know what? It doesn't matter anymore. What matters is that we fight for our freedoms, because you know what? Without our basic liberties, we can't resist, we can't act, and with the way it's going, and I'm going to talk about this in a moment, we can't live. By the end of the year, and I'm going to say something, and it's going to sound awful, but we need to face the truth of what is coming. by the end of the year, this government are set to legislate on carbon passes for domestic use. And when I say domestic use, I don't just mean going to a football match. I don't just mean, going to a gathering. This will be for everything. If you're watching what's going on in France, that's what's coming in the next few months. You will need a COVID health segregation pass to go to your corner shop by the end of the year if we don't rise up and stop this! This isn't just something that's a conspiracy theory anymore. This is your reality that's coming down the road very quickly, and you will not be able to survive. Even the people that feel they're safe in here, that have had the double jabs, they're not going to be able to survive because it's not supposed to stop. It will go on and on and on. You'll need a 6-monthly jab, and then you'll need a jab for this. Then you'll need something else. It won't stop until everybody is ostracized from society. Everybody. Those of you that know your history, as Jeff has been talking very articulately about today, know that it doesn't stop at one group of people. They keep going, as they did in Nazi Germany, as they did in fascist Italy, as they've done in the Soviet Union and communist countries. They go for everybody that does not comply. They will go for them. So we have to stand up now. And something very urgent, as I said, is happening in September or in October. The government is going to pass this legislation. We, and I know you're all going to be cynical about this, and what MPs are like, and I totally get that. Most of them are a bunch of crooks, I understand. But I actually think some of them are libertarians. And we have to try our damnedest to get more to vote against COVID passes. At the moment, are you all familiar with Big Brother Watch?
Yeah,
you all heard of Big Brother Watch. Check out their website. They've got a really good campaign to stop COVID passes, or what I call segregation passes. And at the moment, 85 of our MPs have agreed not to vote for COVID passes. So a round of applause for those MPs. And there are other groups supporting this. But you know what? If we want to stop it, this isn't enough. We need more MPs to vote no. And this is where you come in. I don't know what the majority is here in Norwich and who's the MP or MPs, but if you are in a marginal constituency, which is where the vote is tight, those are the MPs that are going to be worried about their votes. And those are the MPs you have got to take it to vote no to this legislation. So what we're going to be doing, I think, Piers, we talked about this yesterday, is we're going to be taking it to the road, to those marginal constituencies, taking it to those MPs and asking them to vote no to these health segregation passes. And you have a role to play here in Norwich. Those of you here in Norwich, get together now. Don't waste time. Get a street stall up in the high street. Get on the megaphone, have a petition, a localised petition at your local MPs. If you get just, I don't know what the majority is here, maybe Nigel knows, I don't know. But whatever it is, you know, get that petition together. We can come and, I'm sure we can come and visit you as well to support that campaign. And if we can get at least another 50 MPs to say no, we can stop this. Because if we don't try and stop it, you're not going to be able to run off into the hills, guys, and hide. This isn't the 1930s, like it was in Germany, where you could hide in the hills.
Shout louder, they're trying to drown you out.
You're not going to be able to run and hide from this. We're not living in the 1930s. You're not going to be able to run and hide. And I'm so sorry to say, this off-grid dream that people have, that's not going to happen either, because they're going to come for all of us. The only option we've got is to fight this now.
Freedom! Freedom!
Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom! Freedom in over the next few weeks. So please support us, please do that. Pierce is going to get behind this. And finally, we haven't got it on a banner, but there is now a new petition to those remaining MPs on 38 Degrees. So if you go on to 38degrees.com and you type into the search page, no health COVID passes, you will find our petition. Please sign it and share it widely. Thank you.
So we've done the bad, we're now going to do two of the goods, and we're going to end up back in the Big and Whistle for a pint. Yay! So, I hope you guys realise that what we're doing here today is not just Norwich. It isn't about the murderers' pub, it's about the murderers globally. This is just a symbol. This is just one little guy who thinks he's doing the right thing and he's doing something really bad. Just like the businesses did in Nazi Germany. But just like then, there are some very brave people standing up to the council, standing up to the police. God knows how many times Ron in his little deli has been intimidated by council officers, accompanied by police officers who barge into his beautiful cafe. No, sorry, takeaway. I've got to get the words right for legal reasons. They barge into his takeaway and intimidate him, intimidate his family, and intimidate all the customers and prevent them coming in. So we're going to go and say thank you to Kinkies, the hairdressers. We're going to say thank you to Ron. And buy as much as you can today and any other day that you're in town, because we need to support these guys, because the globalists are after little businesses. And anyone who doesn't realise that yet, you're missing something. So murderers, you're going to go down with the rest of them if you don't sort yourselves out. So, I'm going to walk very slowly down towards Kinkies and see you all down there.
Yay! Peter! Yay. I won. Resist.